That's a big dude. Freddie? Freddie. Tagaloa? Fucking low. How do you defend that? Whoa.
Check one. Better there. Okay, that's better. Check one. New York from the 45. Little high. Check one. That's not bad. That'll take a tier. Check one. That's good. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to St. Mary's College in Moraga, California. It is the North Coast Section Basketball Championship Division 4. It's the boys' turn now to take on and challenge for the Division 4 title. We had just seen the girls of Salesian in an amazing, roaring comeback defeat St. Mary's 49-42 in the first game of this afternoon. We've got two more after this one, but right now, the Salesian boys' turn. They've got to have some adrenaline pumping now. After watching the girls win the title, they get an opportunity to take a title, a chance their way themselves against St. Pat's St. Vincent. Salesian, the Pride, are the Division IV champions of last year. They are the defending champions, and they have taken on the Bruins of St. Vincent St. Patrick four times in the last 12 months. They have defeated the Bruins by strong margins each time. But the Bruins, the number 7 seed in the Division IV North Coast title run, playing extremely well and looking for to exact a little revenge tonight, and they get the tip off immediately as St. Vincent in their green and white and gold. They're taking on a tough man-to-man defense of Salesian. They're going to work the weave, looking up top, guard at Jose Flores, and quickly a foul against Salesian. That's going against Davion Mize, the co-captain. Lay it on the floor. And the Bruins will take it out. Set it back up to the top. Flores. Flores now weaving it out to Webster. Webster and Flores, the starting guards. Just underway here in this Division IV North Coast basketball final for the boys. This time a jumper from just inside the arc. No good off the front iron. And Salesian will run it right back. And this team has got speed to burn. They swing it out to the three-point line. A tray on the way, and it's good. And that's Jeffrey Parker. First points of the game, 3-0, Salesian.
Jeffrey Parker is a player that you have to watch out for today. He's a three-point specialist, and he will, if you leave him open, he will hit more and more shots like that.
And Howard Mills joining us here after manning the camera for a few moments. Quick shot underneath, and a good play up and under by Dante. Rather, that's Jason Webster, making the 3-2 Salesian lead. Now the Bruins have lost four straight to Salesian. Three times this season they have lost to this Salesian basketball team. Down baseline, fires it out for a three-point attempt from the left side off the iron. No good, rebound goes to the Bruins. And that's Flores again. He has been handling the ball quite a bit, not only the point position, but he's been working the boards as well. 3-2. Salesian, 6:20 left to go in the first quarter, just underway here in this Division IV title game. I was looking to set this one up again. Ball tipped away, back to Flores. Flores, cross-court pass to Hickman. Hickman in a little bit of trouble, tries to get a backdoor pass, does so. Nice head fake, blocked by Salesian, and it's going the other way, because here come the Pride. Up and under, and that one's blocked by the Bruins. Turnabout fair play, Flores leading the break. Flores going to go up and in all the way, and that's a block party. That's three in a row.
That's Jabari Burr there. Yeah, he is the block party specialist, and he's always throwing them into the wall and stands. And, yeah, this is going to be a good defensive game so far here.
Well, so far it's been a track meet for both teams trying to set the tempo. And the big men for both squads already getting their palms a little sore from swatting balls away. Trent Rojas at a block the last time down court, and Salesian now going to set it up at the top with Jabari Bird, one of the top juniors in the nation, ranked number 20 by Max Preps, and a lot of Pac-10 teams are looking over him as he stands at the top, setting up the offense. They spread it out, this time a shot away, no good, rebound goes to Hickman, and the Bruins will slow it up.
And it's good to have a point guard like Hickman to be able to run the point, but also grab boards also. That's a big, big help for this team.
Okay. Trent Rojas now going to get underneath the Flores. Flores with some space, trying to get it outside to his big man, Jalen Canty, unable to. And that ball's going to be a turnover going to Salesian. 3-2, the Pride, the defending Division IV champions, are going to take on this scrappy St. Pat's St. Vincent team, who they have defeated three times already this season, one time by 50 points. But don't expect a repeat of that performance tonight. Some good movement of the ball around the perimeter. Salesian quick on the passes. This time they're going to cut through the lane, get a lot of contact, no good. Rebound going to Salesian. They're going to kick it right back to Green. Three-point attempt now from the top. Bounces off the back iron, and the rebound going to the Bruins. So far, Salesian's trouble trying to find the basket.
Yeah, St. Vincent, St. Patrick playing great basketball.
Now, talk about it right there. Jason Webster slices through the lane and gives the Bruins a 4-3 lead.
They're trying, St. Patrick, St. Vincent's trying to end the streak that Salesian's had a hold on them and trying to get this monkey off their back.
So Salesian will set up their spread offense. This time a drive looking for something. He's blocked into the key. He's going to spring it out again. That's Mario Dunn. Dunn kicks it back inside. Ball's off somebody's hands, and that's going to the Bruins. Boy, that is some tough, gritty defense the St. Pat, St. Vincent team's playing right now.
That's something that they're going to definitely have to do.
4:11 left to go in this first quarter. North Coast Division IV title matchup. The Cinderella story, the Bruins, from their 7-seed position all the way to the title game. And right now, Coach Derek Walker wants to talk about it, calls a timeout for St. Pat St. Vincent with 3:59 left to go in the first quarter. And St. Vincent with a 4-3 lead. Check me on that. That's Salesian 4-3.
That's a 4-3, yeah, you're right.
I'm sure I've got the right score.
Yeah, but St. Vincent.
Bruins?
St. Vincent, St. Patrick, like you talk about the Cinderella story, coming all the way from the seventh seed and to come back here and play in this championship game tells you enough right there that they're coming into this game versus Legion a whole different attitude in the way they approach this.
Well, this is a rematch of last year's North Coast Division IV final where Salesian defeated St. Pat St. Vince 67-55. And they've played three times this season, twice in January, once in February. One game was an ugly 74-24 whitewash. Salesian just drubbing the St. Pat's St. Vince team. But this is a different Bruins program right now. This is a team on the rise and a team that has a lot of momentum. And right now, great defense by Salesian. They're trapping. And the Bruins has got to move the ball. 8 seconds on the shot clock. As Webster with the ball. Got to get rid of it. Loses his dribble. He's got to toss it up. And it doesn't even hit the shot clock. That was a great defensive stand by Salesian, and the Bruins absolutely confused.
Yeah, that was excellent defense by Salesian here to press the man all the way into the clock, ran down. Great job.
Five on the floor for Salesian. Mario Dunn, Markel Leonard, Davion Mize, Jabari Bird, and Jeffrey Parker. As Markel Leonard leads the charge, and Leonard with the ball. He's right on the three-point line. He's going to shoot that up and drill it. 6-4 Salesian, 3:13 left to go in the first quarter.
Salesian can shoot the ball. They have excellent shooters on this team.
They do, all over the place. Right now, it is a suffocating man-to-man defense that Salesian's playing against the Bruins, and they're really struggling against it. Need more motion out of the Bruin offense. And they're not getting it. Everyone below the free throw line. Just going to launch this one up for three and drills it. Whoa. How about that? Jason Webster, 6 foot junior.
Excellent shot. Just going to put it up deep from the three-point line. Almost NBA range and drained it.
He had nowhere else to go with it. Shot clock was winding down, and he drills the three. It's a one-point lead for the Bruins this time. Right back at you is Markel Leonard.
And you cannot leave these Salesian shooters open like that. They will drill all day long.
9-7, the pride. As Flores leading the charge for the Bruins. This time picked off, intercepted. That's Bird. Bird's going to send it back out. Look out, it could be pretty. No! They attempted the alley-oop dunk. Good defense by the Bruins. But Bird will go on the line to shoot two on the foul.
And that was a very smart foul by St. Vincent, St. Patrick. That's the way you want to foul if you're going to foul.
Trent Rojas called for his first foul. Second team foul for the Bruins. And Bird misses the front end of two. 6'5 junior being looked at by Cal, Washington, and Arizona right now. And into the game comes the big man. And when I say big, I'm talking 6'8, 3'10 big, Freddie Tagaloa, the senior center. Bird's second offering is good. And Salesian extends their lead to 10-7. As Rojas will take it out for the Bruins. And there's a full court pressure now, man to man. They're not going to let St. Pat, St. Vincent breathe it all down court. There's Cyrus Scales now in the game at guard for the Bruins. Scales swings it out to Flores. Flores going to drive the lane, loses the ball. Bird picks it up. And now to meet Leonard with the ball. He's going to try to put that up on himself. Finger roll, no good, but he's fouled on his way up by Cyrus Scales. And he'll go to the line to shoot two.
Another smart foul by St. Vincent St. Patrick.
They can't run with Salesian. And they shouldn't really be even thinking about trying. They've got some nice guards in Flores, who's got good speed, Scales as well. But this Salesian team's got speed to burn from every position. As Leonard hits his first of two free throws, 11-7 Salesian lead. Bruins need to think about slowing down and setting up their offense and not getting into a track meet right now.
Yes, because there's a track meet, they will lose. They try to run, like you said earlier. Salesian has just too much speed. St. Vincent, St. Patrick needs to play smarter and kind of slow it down here and just look for the open shots.
And here's the trap. And Salesian all over Scales, but a foul is going to be charged against Salesian. I'm not sure it might be going against Harrison. No, Markel Leonard will get his first personal foul on a reach-in. Third team foul for Salesian, something they need to watch, something as they get caught in. Now look at the big man down low is at the high post. It's Tagaloa. Trying to work around this man-to-man. Three-point attempt by the Bruins. It rolls off no good. Tagaloa with the rebound. That boy's lumbering down court. Look at him go. As Leonard going to scoot through the lane. He's going to fire it out to the wing for a three-point attempt. No good. Whistle on the floor. And we're waiting to see what the indication is by the official. And that's a personal foul against Jason Webster of St. Vincent St. Pat's. That'll be his first personal. And back into the game for Salesians, number three, Mario Dunn, their starting guard. And Dunn with the ball now, going to set it up. 1:17 left to go in the first quarter, 11-7 Salesian. And now, too many steps by Jermaine Edwards. And Salesian turns the ball over back to the Bruins. A lot of substitutions right now. You're seeing a lot of fresh legs coming in and out of the game for both teams. And that one's stripped away. And Salesian on the break. Great pass on the inbound. Ball's up. And a beautiful play. Bernard Ward, recipient of that pass.
That's the speed you was talking about. As you see, they just fly down the court. And St. Vincent St. Patrick cannot catch up in time to get down there and play defense.
Trapping zone behind the timeline. They got to get rid of it. They finally get it across midcourt. And they just can't hold on to it. They're having all types of trouble controlling the basketball. Finally, Salesian's going to be called for a foul. That's Jawan Harrison for reaching in. But really, the guards for the Bruins, just absolute chaos against this swarming, trapping defense of the Pride.
Yeah, they just can't take all this pressure right now as they can barely advance the ball past half court. And just Salesian's just playing that in-your-face, strong, tough defense right now.
Just like the girls did in the first half. Salesian Lady Pride won the Division 4 title game against St. Mary's 49-42 in an amazing comeback game. The boys looking to do the same here in the Division 4 men's final. As the Bruins with the ball looking to swing it around, get it out to the side perimeter. Back out to the top, a three-point attempt by the Bruins. Way short, going to be rebounded by Salesian. And on the run comes Mize. And Harrison is fouled near the baseline after Harrison kind of throwing an elbow up. But a foul against the Bruins there. Looks like their 15th foul. With 21 seconds left to go in the first quarter. And Salesian with a 13-7 lead. Bruins still hanging tough, trailing only by six. And a good interception there by Canty.
Way to be aware.
Good turnover by the Bruins. They get the ball back. 13 seconds left. Shot and game clock even. Webster yo-yoing up and down. Looks like he's going to try to take the last shot. He does. And air balls it. No good. Thrown all the way back. And the ball dead at midcourt. And in speed fashion, the Salesian Pride take a 13-7 first quarter lead over St. Vincent St. Pat's here in this Division 4 championship game.
Hey, KBCSports.com will be providing live audio coverage of the state regional basketball championships as well as the finals. March Madness comes to high school basketball in California on March 17th for the regional basketball championships. Four venues of coverage around the state. Then the following weekend, March 23rd and 24th, it's the California State Basketball Championships. You can catch it all on KBCSports.com, your home for high school sports.
And we thank you for joining us here on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv. I'm T.C. Wardell alongside my partner, Howard Mills. And we've got the brothers Grimm, I like to call them, Stephen and James Davies, working the camera and the laptop. The start of quarter number two in this boys' Division IV championship game. Salesian 13, St. Vincent, St. Pat's 8.
And with all the mistakes St. Vincent, St. Patrick's has made, they're pretty much in this game after this first quarter, so let's see what they can do in the second period.
They've played better than expected. This Bruins team has really fighting and battling off the Salesian team. But the Pride is known to wear you down, not only with speed, but with size and power. And someone like Tagaloa at 6'8", 3'10", he's a load in the key.
Yeah, it's definitely hard to push out of there. Definitely hard to push out of there.
Big man, big man. So we open the second quarter. Salesian with the basketball. Leonard takes it across the timeline. She's over to Edwards. Back over. And now a whistle on the floor. And that one's going to go against Salesian. Little naughty happenings there in the key. Nobody gets to see except the official. Fourth team foul for the Pride as the Bruins will get the ball in the turnover. And trying to get the ball in is a task in itself. And they're sticking man-to-man here. And Mario Dunn staying right with the guards. And Scales locked in the corner, finally able to get it out. Shot up and no good. Big rebound, almost tipped away, and it was. Salesian on the run now. Leonard loses the ball. Picked up, and everybody's on the ground right now.
Tagaloa falling over to St. Patrick's player.
No,
and he was able to pop back up after
that. Trent Rojas was on the bottom of that pile, and Tagaloa just lumbered over him like a fallen tree. That's the last guy I want falling on me. So Rojas will take the ball out for the Bruins. 13-7. Relatively low score here. St. Vincent, St. Pat's has done a good job of trying to keep the score down and staying in this ball game against this much faster Salesian team. As Flores brings the ball up with 7:22 left to go in the first half. Rojas looking for a man. Dangerous pass, but picked up by Webster. Webster Luke picks up his dribble. He's covered well. Back to Rojas. Rojas is going baseline. And he runs right into Tagaloa. Tagaloa didn't do anything but stand there like a wall. Transition basketball and scored for Salesian. That's Jeffrey Parker, rather. That is Jermaine Edwards with the points. 15-7. Oh, man.
The speed inside. And Tagaloa on the inside, just like you said, standing there like just a big redwood tree. And there's nothing you can do about that.
Looking around the perimeter. They're going to send it back up to the top to Flores. Stifling man-to-man defense. Nearly stolen. And now swinging back into the key, slicing through, teardrop, no good. But on the second hot, good shot by Jalen Canny to pick up the garbage off the glass and to make it a 15-9 Salesian advantage.
They need more of that, getting offensive rebounds, getting second chance advantages.
6:22 left to go in the second quarter. Big man Tagaloa comes all the way out, and they keep spreading the field. Mize now back inside to Edwards. Good rule motion, but this time they lose the ball. Maybe one pass too many for Salesian. And on the turnover, here come the Bruins. Cyrus Scales taking the ball. He's got to be careful with it. He's got a man, a thief on him in Edwards. And now a foul on the floor. This one's going against the Bruins. And the ball will go the other way to Salesian. That's their 16th foul.
Both teams doing a lot, making a lot of turnovers here early in this game. Just have to slow it down.
Game moving pretty quickly. 5:57 left to go in the first half. It's only 15-9, a Salesian lead, but they're just hanging on to it. As the Bruins really battling hard, being as scrappy as you can find to stay into this ball game. Salesian, the defending Division IV champions, looking to make it two in a row this time. Slicing through the lane is Mize, and Mize is fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two. Davian Mines, one of the co-captains for this Salesian Pride team, finished the regular season 29-2, currently ranked number 39 nationally. They're ranked in the state number 4, and in the state, California State Division 4, they're the top-ranked team. And they're going to make some noise in the postseason here in the California State playoffs.
Yeah, definitely. They just, their speed and their size on the inside, they can keep up with, I believe, anybody in the state of California.
First offering from the free throw line by Davian Mize is good, 6 foot senior guard. 5:46 left to go in the half. As we now have some timeout called by the officials on the court, they may be looking at the clock. Now they're going to bring in another player for the Bruins. The 6'7 freshman coming into the game, Ryan Stewart. For St. Vincent St. Pat's, he comes in the game, replaces Jalen Canty.
6'7" freshman.
We got a young team.
he might be pushing 7'3" by the time he gets.
Put some groceries in this kid, and he's definitely gonna be doing that. Second free throw is good for Mize, and it's a 17-9 advantage for Salesian. 5:42 left to go in the first half. As Flores gets a little too cute with his dribble, almost loses it between his legs. Flores charging in, going to swing it back out to the big 6'7 freshman. Back to Flores, again more motion because Salesian's all over. Florence is going to put that one up from nowhere. Didn't draw iron, and he hits the canvas, and here comes Salesian quickly down court. Spin move inside the key, and he got travel. He took about 2 extra steps, him being Mize, and the ball will turn right back over to the Bruins.
And Flores on the other end, kind of just putting the ball up, not waiting for an open shot, kind of just a little desperation shot there.
Need to set up that offense for the Bruins. They need more motion out of their players behind the free throw line. And now back to a man-to-man press. And they're able to get the ball into Flores barely. And he's being marked by Bernard Ward. Actually, he's being marked by Mario Dunn.
He has to get across the floor.
He does. He's trying to be too fancy with the ball. And now he just gave it to one of his players and able to give it away to Flores. This time a 15-footer from the wing. No good. Tip back out to Canty. Canty's going to put this one up again, and this time, again, no good off the rim, and a rebound to Salesian. That's Bird. He's got height, and he can run. That's 6'5", this silky smooth junior. He's going to try to go in the key. He ran into 3 guys, pinballed off 2 of them, and Flores is going to get called with a foul.
Yeah, he tried to muscle up through there, but doesn't have enough strength to go through the size of that, the inside of St. Vincent St. Patrick right now.
Yeah, Bird's 6'5", but he doesn't have a whole lot of meat on him. And he tried to take on 3 Bruins, tried to cut right through all of them. Unsuccessful, but did draw the foul. And the rebound, no good. That was a 1-on-1, no good. Rebound to the Bruins. And here comes Webster from guard position. 4:39 left to go in the first half of play here, 17-9 Salesian. And now another traveling call, this time against Trent Rojas.
That comes from not playing. That comes from not slowing it down and setting your offense up, just trying to rush shots and get whatever you can, and you get a lot of turnovers and traveling calls like that.
Yeah, and you don't want your 6'4", you know, power forward handling the ball at the top of the key.
Exactly.
So Salesian will take it out on their side of the court. 4:33 left to go in the first half. 17-9, the Pride, reigning Division IV champions, looking to make it 2 in a row. This time, shot from the wing. Good 3-pointer for Jermaine Edwards. And he's starting to heat up. 29, Salesian. And this time, done with the steal. And looking to steal back is Cyrus Scales. But while doing so, he causes a foul. And that'll be the 9th team foul against the Bruins. And that'll send Dunn to the line to shoot 1-1.
This defense that Salesian Pride is playing right now is just proving to be too much for St. Vincent St. Patrick.
You need to work on breaking that press because Salesian's really, putting the chokehold on them behind the timeline. 4:12 left to go until halftime. Dunn from the free throw line absolutely misses the free throw. I'm not sure he even drew iron on that.
They got good shooters on this team, but when it comes to free throws, it looks like they're struggling a little bit.
And he kind of just jogs to the sideline and says, I think I'll take a breather, coach. I don't think I want to see that one be shown on television. So the front end of the 1-on-1, no good. In fact, it misses altogether. 20-9, Salesian with the lead. 4:12 left to go in the half. And once again, Bruins are going to work hard to get the ball across midcourt. And this time, they're going to catch Harrison again, the sophomore guard, for reaching in against Scales. And he's giving Scales all kinds of trouble.
I know you'll see a lot of that from Salesian reaching in because they go for steals. They go for steals, and they average a lot of steals per game. And they got a lot here so far, but that's what they like to do. They have to get in your face and like to get the turnovers. And so you'll see a lot of those calls today.
Well, Mize comes back in the game for Salesian. 4:05 left to go in the second quarter. Salesian up by 11. This time swing pass to the baseline. There's a three-point attempt. No good. Rebound Salesian. And the Pride is on the run again. Bird fires it down court to Edwards. Edwards for three. Oh, he's 3-for-3 from that spot. He's feeling it.
Yes, sir. He's on fire. They keep leaving him open in the corner like that. That's his sweet spot. And he'll hit it every time.
Edwards liking that spot from the right baseline. And now Derek Walker says, I got to call a timeout and slow the Salesian team down. So timeout call by St. Vincent St. Pat's with 3:39 left to go until halftime. It's 23-9 Salesian.
You can watch highlights or replay of today's game in our on-demand section, and you can also buy a DVD or Blu-ray of today's game right on CIFNorthCoast.tv. Click on Buy DVD, and you can order today's game right now. Have a game that lasts a lifetime. Brought to you by CIFNorthCoast.tv.
T.C. Wardell alongside Howard Mills here from St. Mary's College in Pastoral, Moraga, California. It is game 2 of 4 today in the North Coast section. We've already seen the Salesian Lady Pride in a tremendous comeback victory against St. Mary's, 49-42, to take the Division IV title. Now it's the men's turn to go back-to-back for their Division IV crown. They lead St. Patrick's 23-9 with 3:39 left to go until halftime. And, Howard, I'm not sure what the Bruins need to do at this point.
Well, they just have to slow it down. They're moving way too fast. They haven't letting this game get out of hand, but if they can just slow it down and take more open shots and get these shots to drain, I believe they can get back into this game, because Salesian, they're making their fair share of mistakes too, and the Bruins have to capitalize on those mistakes. That's the only way they will be able to get back into this game.
Absolutely right. Absolutely right, and back into the left to go. Bringing the ball across the timeline is Webster. Need more movement out of the Bruins down low. They're not doing a thing. They have their feet stuck in cement. And look at Tagaloa is hit for a foul. I think he causes a foul just by walking on the court. The big 6'8", 310-pound forward. And a second foul of the game. He'll go sit down and take up about half the bench.
And Tagaloa, also one of the stars of Salesian's football team.
You think?
They're big stars. Yeah. And yeah, he was definitely a monster on the field, that's for sure.
So the 1-1, no good by Canty for the Bruins. Can't capitalize on the free throw attempt. 3:24 left to go in the first half as Bird brings the ball down court for Salesian. Nice pass inside, and no good, but a rebound off the glass. No good for Salesian. This time it's a battle for the basketball. Who comes up with it? It's Salesian, and he has fouled. Davion Mize fighting with the green jerseys. On second and third chance shots, they are really getting position and out-jumping this Bruin team. I'm looking at that 6'7 freshman for St. Vincent St. Pat's. He is one lean young man.
Yeah, and like you said earlier, get some groceries in him and get some size on him. And only as a freshman at 6'7", he can be incredible. He can be incredible for the team. Right. I'm interested in hearing his name in the future.
Putting him on a weight program. Front end of two, no good by Salesian. As the young freshman comes out of the game. Second free throw attempt, also no good. There's a lost artist free throw shooting. Rebound goes to the Bruins.
Salesian's field goal percentage has not been looking good so far, and these are the opportunities that I talked about that the Bruins have to capitalize on.
Flores bringing the ball up court. Bringing out to Rojas. Rojas to Webster. Webster looking to do something against this man-to-man defense. Rojas nowhere to go. Webster being just beaten on. Now the free throw line blocked from behind by Robinson. And the ball goes to Bird, and now the ball is lost, and Rojas somehow finds his way with it. Everybody's losing the basketball now, and back on the attack come the Bruins. Shot by Webster from 16, no good.
They have to get those shots to fall. They have to get those shots to fall.
Salesian on the attack. Fires back outside from three-pointer. He looked at it. Now he's going to step on the line. Oh, four in a row.
And number 35 Salesian.
That's Jeffrey Parker.
Jeffrey Parker looking like Ray Allen out here from the Boston Celtics.
Oh, and a steal. This looks like the dunk. It is. Jermaine Edwards with the steal and the jam. And it's 28-9. And Derek Walker needs a timeout before this one gets completely out of hand.
Salesian's starting to get into their rhythm now, and they are starting to just put on the show like that you see out of them every game now.
Salesian with a 19-point advantage with 2:05 left to go until halftime here in the Division IV North Coast Men's Final.
Stay tuned for the CIFNorthCoast.tv postgame show where we will select our player of the game as well as wrap up all the action from this ball game. That's coming up following the game on CIFNorthCoast.tv.
T.C. Wardell alongside Howard Mills from St. Mary's College, where the division of the North Coast Men's and Women's Basketball Championship being held here for Division 3 and 4 today. We saw the Division 1 men's and women's games yesterday. Not a good day for Deer Valley High School, as both their men's and women's team really took it on the chin yesterday.
Both teams kind of have that same style of play, a lot of sloppy play, a lot of turnovers, and just not good all the way around. Not a good home going for them, but for Salesian High School, with their women winning earlier, now the men looking to take one home, that's going to be a great home going for them.
No kidding. De La Salle, just up the road, they won the men's Division I championship. So congratulations to the Spartans. But right now, the Bruins of St. Vincent St. Pat's trying to find a formula to get back in this game against this stifling Salesian basketball team. The Pride, the defending Division IV champions, looking to make it two in a row. As Webster is bothered by Dunn. There's some long cross-court pass, and this time they can't hang on to it. And there's a bounce pass right down the line. That's Edwards on the layup and the foul. Jermaine Edwards, junior forward, hits the layup and is fouled. He'll go to the line to complete the three-point play, and there is nobody in the gym that can keep up with the Salesian basketball team.
Can they run? I mean, this is incredible. It looks like they could just run all day long with anybody.
I think that was Mario Dunn. And correct me if I'm wrong, Howard, but I think that was Mario Dunn who made that incredible long bounce pass down court to Edwards.
Yes, that was Dunn to Edwards.
1:43 left to go until halftime, and right now St. Vincent St. Pat's wishes it was halftime so they can catch their collective breaths. They trail 30-9 against Salesian, and the Salesian not putting the foot off the gas. They're still pressing. And this time Edwards is going to be called for the foul, reaching in, and they're not particularly happy with that call. That should be the 8th team foul against Salesian, and that'll send Flores to the line to shoot 1-1. Man, there just isn't any weakness on the bench for the Salesian basketball team. They go about 9 deep. They got a 4x100-meter relay team. They probably could field 2 of them.
Yeah, I wouldn't. That would be interesting to see what these boys can do on the track.
Yeah, absolutely. So Flores on the line to shoot 1-1 for the Bruins. First offering is perfect. And St. Vincent St. Pat's finally into double digits, trailing 30-10 with 1:42 left to go until halftime.
And only down by 20 before the half. Still a chance to get into this game. Just opportunities for 3 points like this, these free throws and open shots can get them back into this game. But I believe with play like that, they can get back into this game.
Flores hits both free throws, 30-11, Salesian. Yeah, I agree, Howard. They're going to have to just kind of chip away, not get out of their game, not get in too much of a hurry, and just kind of piecemeal it and do all they can defensively against Salesian, who's really had their way on offense against them. As Dunn brings the ball down, back to the rim. He's hit three there already. Oh, that one's in and out for Edwards.
Very close.
It was. Rebound goes to the Bruins. Opportunity now with 1:25. And Webster sees an opportunity. He's going to shoot that one. No good off the front iron. Rebound, everybody in white. That's Parker with the board. Bird coming down. He's going to slice through the lane. Loses it. Trying to do too much. And he's going to tie it up with Bird down on the floor. Nobody wants to get up right now. Everyone's tangled up. And a little bit of push in there, getting off that pile. 1:10 left to go until halftime.
Players starting to get a little testy now.
A little bit. They're getting a little frustrated, this Bruins team. That was number 24, Jordan Hickman, fighting Bird for the ball, and they're going to give the basketball over to the Bruins on possession. Webster on the inbound, 1:08 left to go in this first half. As Dunn all over Webster, but Dunn's going to get called for another foul.
Another reach in. That's something that, you know, you're going to see more and more of that in. Hey, if the Salesian wants to give these free points to the Bruins, then they can take it.
This is the kind of opportunities that the Bruins really need to make up, as we were talking about. This is only his first team foul. I thought it was like his fifth in the first half.
And the Bruins' field goal percentage are a lot better than Salesian, so this is a way they can get back into the game.
It is an opportunity here, and they now trail 30-12, the Salesian. 1:03 left to go until halftime. Webster on the second offering on the free throw line. That's how you get back into it. Hits the second. Trail now by 17 with just 1 minute to play in the half. As Dunn slowly brings the ball down court. 26 on the shot clock, 53 on the game clock. 3-2 defense now shown by this Bruins team. Someone left him under open watch. Parker standing by his lonesome under the basket, and they find him. And he hits the two, 32-13. 38 seconds left to play. As Webster now fires it out to the wing. Run the pump fake inside. That's a nice pass. Off the glass, no good by Hickman. And back on the attack comes Salesian. This time, ball stripped away, but it's going to be a foul against the Bruins. Looking for the number, though. I can't tell.
Yeah.
Actually, that's a number we don't have. Boy, we don't have that number. That's not on our roster, but a foul against the Bruins. And Mize at the free throw line hits his first shot, 33-12. Now they're 33-13, a 20-point lead for Salesian with only 23 seconds left to go in the second quarter. And Mize perfect on the second. As we get some relief on the ground, number 22 in the game, Michael Page for Salesian. Number 23, Jalen Canny coming in now for the Bruins. Game clock is off, 16 seconds. And the shot clock is off. Looking to find inside. A lot of pressure in the paint. Backs everyone down on the skyhook. No good. And the ball tipped out of bounds by the Bruins and will go to Salesian with 4.3 seconds left to go.
That was an excellent, excellent back down by number 23. Canty got right up under the basket. His chance could not capitalize. I think they should give him more feeds on the inside if he's easily able to back down his opponent like that.
Yeah, he was not afraid. He was going up against three Salesian players in the paint, and he just backed him up and made a nice baby hook shot. As Dunn fires down court, 2 seconds left. It's going to be a three-point attempt at the buzzer. No good. But Salesian is going to jump off the court, and St. Vincent, St. Pat's are going to go into the locker room looking for some oxygen as the Pride take a 34-13 halftime lead into the locker room. Folks, we'll be back in just a few moments here with our halftime show. So we thank you for joining us, and stay tuned on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv. .316 left to go in this ball game. High formation, 3rd and 3 from the 45 of the Wolverines. And this time, holy cow! Deion almost hands it to the Westview player. He's going to run this to the 5-10. Touchdown, Wolverines! How did that happen?
Jason
that was
Snyder.
Holy cow! He was in the backfield before the running back could even get the handoff. He took the handoff from Deion.
He took the ball right out of Deion's hands and just...
Holy cow!
Can't say I've seen that one very often.
Snyder comes shooting in from the A-gap. I think Deion froze when he saw him. He's ready to hand off to his running back. He froze when he saw him and just let him have the ball.
12 seconds to go.
Oh, you could hear a pin drop.
5, 4, 3, 2. Get the snap off. Last play of the game. Brewster rolls right. Gets away from two sacks. Dons win. Sack at the 20-yard line. What a game.
and number 40, Lucas Zinder, with the game-saving sack. And there is heartbreak on one sideline and a jubilation on another.
Offset eye for the Grizzlies as Keeney takes it under center. They'll send a man in motion, pitch back to Bird on the sweep. Bird finds a seam. He might go, folks. 20, 15, 10. Drags a tackler. Touchdown. Bird goes 38 yards for the touchdown on the sweep.
One more snap is all it's going to take. And there you have it, folks. Your 2011 Division I Sac Joaquin section champions, the Granite Bay Grizzlies, as they defeat Pleasant Grove 30-24.
Jacqueline Williamson, her serve is over, dug by Holt. Giblin going back to Holt near side, cut shot, kept alive, back in one by Cathedral, and this one is out as Caston on Hill sends it wide, and the Cathedral Dons have won the title 16-14 in game five.
Thomas with the ball, swings it out to Norris. Cameron Taylor tried to block that one away. Norris with a strong take, blocked by BJ Anya. Huge block. Robinson leading the break the other way, gets it to Grant.
Oh!
Slam dunk, Jeremy Grant off the feed from James Robinson. What a play by the Stag.
Hancock to his immediate left. Two receivers far side, one near side. Hancock on a counter, right side. He's inside the 10. He bounces off a tackler at the 10. The 5, touchdown Helix. And behind Hancock, the field is littered with white jerseys on the turf.
Wow. Hancock not to be outdone by his fellow playmakers on offense. Put on a show on that short 12-yard touchdown run. Looked like he was down after 3 yards. Just threw a defender on the ground.
As sophomore Chris Carter steps under center. In their tight wing formation, Lycos in motion. Second back through is Freeman. Freeman just knocking people over. Look at him run. Breaks through. Four tackles. And now it's just a foot race to the end zone. And Freeman's going to go the distance. Touchdown Imperial on the first play of the second half.
Second and 6 for Imperial from their own 47. They're going to give it to Freeman again off the right, left side. And Freeman gets by one wave and down across the 20, 40-yard line. Still on his feet. Look at him run down to the 20-yard line. One man to beat. Gets by him. Touchdown, Freeman. How did he do that? Holy cow. 64-yard touchdown run. His fifth of the game. Royce Freeman, ladies and gentlemen, you're about to see the top rushing and the as I look over to our partners at KXO Radio, the top rusher
wow.
in the San Diego section for the next 2 years.
That's just amazing. That is just amazing. They hit him in the backfield. They hit him at the line of scrimmage. They hit him a couple yards downfield. They hit him again near
the goal line. No 5-second count can be started. Nobody was close enough defensively. Lyle's going to swing left side. Robinson. Here is a backdoor lob
there
for Grant. They've been wanting that all game. And they got it, 50-42. They lulled you to sleep, and then they hit Grant on the back door.
They trail by 2. McMorrow's kick is on the way, and it is good. St. Augustine has their first lead of the game. 21-20 with 25 seconds to play. The senior McMorrow with a huge kick. Not the longest of his career, but the biggest of his career.
Oh,
St. Augustine leads it 21.
They're already lining up. They won't even have to run that one more play. They just acquiesce.
Yeah, why bother?
So there you have it. Your 5-time defending Division III champions, the Cathedral Catholic Dons, running up over and through Olympian 41-0 here from Qualcomm Stadium.
Patriots down 21-17. Great ball game here. Dillon taking it, looking right, throwing it up top to Gaines. It will be caught by Gaines. Oh, my goodness. It looked like the defender had it, but Gaines stole it away from him. Jason Gaines, are you kidding me, my friend? Oh, boy. It looked like for sure we had an interception by the Tories, but as they both were going to the ground, Jason Gaines just wrestled it away from him. Shane Dillon to Jason Gaines on an 11-yard play.
Fanchin in the game, now out, replaced by Hayashi, the libero for defense. Wenzel serve, championship point, ball up in the air. Hayashi's going to bring it back. Richards, deep one, over and three. Free opportunity, look for Wallace. No, they go Becker. Hayashi, then tap over and two by Hollingsworth. Now look for Wallace for the match.
Kathleen Wallace, no better way for the Bulls to finish it than giving it to their senior leader.
25-12, 25-15, and with eight straight points to close out their third straight D5 championship on a kill by Kathleen Wallace, 25-21 in game three. Branson has won the D5 title.
To the backfield, it's Hernandez and Northcutt. Set to throw is Thomas. Has time. Goes for the home run. It's intercepted in the end zone. Seemed like they tried to go to Martin, and Martin slipped. Stockton, Hillmar, and Escalon. That's going to do it, folks. Victory formation. Take a kneel. The clock comes out. The clock will tick down. The players jumping up at midfield. I think I see a Gatorade. Did we have a Gatorade shower?
We most certainly did. Casey Taylor getting the shower there. Very much deserved.
Down to 12.
Great tackle there by Ronald Williams there to make the stop for Helix.
And the Helix fans are starting to celebrate here. This is going to be the final play. 5 seconds. Pow Pow will hand it off. And they're going to get in the end zone. Touchdown. That's Keegan who gets in. But that's going to be the end of the ball game. 44-6. Will be the score. So Oceanside scores on the final play of the ball game.
And gets a consolation prize just to make this is kind of say that, hey, we didn't get shut out.
So 44-6 is your score. And Helix is celebrating on the sideline. Oceanside streak of 7 straight championship games has been ended.
2 minutes and 5 seconds left on the clock. Clock rolling, 3rd down and 15 for the Patriots. Dillon, he's got time, steps up. He's going to chuck it deep. He's got a man open. Seth Collins with a diving catch. He hauls it in at the 25. Oh, my goodness.
I'll tell you right there. Dillon goes to show why he is a Division I prospect as he's able to step up, elude the pressure, see Collins down the field, and make the connection. As I'll tell you right now, there has not been a bigger catch for Seth Collins this entire season.
Fans nervously wait on the far side. Trips right. Vernon, the lone receiver to the left. Troy Zien rolls right. Here we go. And he's going to be... Oh, he gets away, but can't get away from the second slew. Vacaville takes over on downs, and the crowd erupts. So does the sideline. Got to watch it. Got to watch the sideline here.
Yeah.
Remember, they were up 35-26. Two unanswered touchdowns. That's going to do it, folks. Your 2011 Division II Sac Joaquin Section Champions, the Vacaville Bulldogs. They win 39-35 in a
classic. 3rd and 4 from the 24-yard line. If this kick is made, I think I know who our player of the game is, unless Escalon can pull a rabbit out of the hat. Snap down. Hole is good. Kick from Bancourt. It's through the uprights. It is good. Bancourt gets lifted up by his holder. Hillmar is up 20-17 with 19.5 seconds left. The fans across from us on the Hillmar side of things waving their yellow and green pom-poms, or should I say gold and green pom-poms, reaching decibel levels unheard of right now.
And we are back on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv. It is preparing for the second half of the men's Division IV final. And it has been all Salesian here in the first half, 34-13 as we get underway here in the second half of play. T.C. Wardell alongside Howard Mills. And Salesian takes the ball in. And they'll start with the ball and swing it outside. They're going to
work the perimeter and fire back inside against this 2-3 zone. This ball's tipped up in the air. Rojas with a tough rebound off to Flores. Flores is going to fire it down court. And a nice second pass. Webster with the body, got contact, makes the shot, didn't hit the foul, but a nice start for the Bruins.
Great way to come out, way to come out. That's how they want to start this second half. They have to, like you said earlier, chip away at this lead. They can't try to do too much, just chip away.
Jabari Bird, long shot. Nice follow by Parker. Gets the bucket and the foul.
When you have Salesian with athletes as they have, it's just hard to play against this team. It's hard to do.
Jeffrey Parker, the 6'5 senior, following up on the glass and gets hammered. And he'll go to the line to complete a three-point play. 7:24 left to go in this third period. We're just underway here in the second half of this Division IV Boys Championship. Defending Division IV champion Salesian taking on St. Vincent, St. Pat's out of Vallejo, California.
St. Vincent, St. Pat have to try to get more motion in their post area.
And there you go. Three-point attempt good. And the official's going to the sideline. There's a player down behind the bucket.
I didn't see him back there behind the
goal. I didn't either. Jordan Hickman hits the three-pointer, but there's appears to be a Bruins player down. Yeah, and he's hidden from our view. We can't see him from behind the basket. But they're going to count the three-pointer. 36-17. Two? Thank you. As Stephen Davies corrects me, it's a two-point shot.
I think what might have happened when the player went out and swatted the ball back in, it looked like he slipped on something. Something wet back there. Floor wasn't dry and might have ran into the wall back there, and that's what it's looking like.
So we have an injury timeout on the court. We'll see who the injured player is. He's up on his own power. Looks like he might be a little groggy.
I believe that's number 23. Their big man.
Oh, Jalen Canning, the 6'6 sophomore. Not someone they can afford to have out of the game. And like you were saying, Howard, he was flashing through the key on the drive. And after he dished off, he may have continued right into the wall.
That's what it looks like, because he's standing up. It looks like he's kind of groggy there a little bit. They're trying to hold him up, so hopefully he's okay.
7:05 left to go in this third period. It's Salesian, the defending Division IV champion, looking to go back-to-back, currently holding a 36-17 advantage over St. Vincent St. Pat's. And St. Vincent St. Pat's, interesting story coming into this season. This is actually a rematch of last year's North Coast Division IV section title, where Salesian won 67-55. Since that time, these two teams have played each other three times this year, three times in 2012, and each time Salesian has really just run over the Bruins. The worst shellacking was back in January 9th, a 74-24 victory over the Bruins, and walking off now on his own power, and that's a good sign, is Jalen Canty.
Yeah, he's definitely holding his head there. He sits down on the bench, and hopefully he can get back into this game. This is a player that they need to be grabbing boards for them and giving them opportunities on the inside.
Now they're playing small ball now as Scales comes into the game. They got three guards in the game now for the Bruins. Clock running at 7:03 left in the third quarter. And Salesian starts to play back up with Markel Leonard at the point. Leonard swings back over to Edmonds. And this time Leonard for three drills it. And sinks the three, 39-17 Salesian.
How frustrating is this for St. Vincent St. Patrick? I mean, they're doing what they have to do to make points, and Salesian just keeps coming back with their own. And they're coming back with big threes.
And Webster having all kinds of trouble trying to get the ball in against Dunn, trying to find someone in the key. And this time, a foul against the Bruins, going to give the ball on the turnover to Salesian. Second team foul for the Bruins. Rojas is going to be called for his first. And quickly down court comes Leonard and the Pride. They're going to move around the perimeter looking for the big man Bird inside, but they're not afraid to shoot it from the wing, as Edmonds is seeing the three-pointers and shooting through the key himself as Leonard. That's a lot of bravery cutting through the big trees. Not able to get the ball down and quickly down now with the Bruins. And speaking of going into the big trees, Webster tries to go against some of the big men into the paint and gets fouled.
Got a lot of brave guards here.
That's what you want to do, is to go in and draw the foul, try to get the points from the line, and see what you can do here.
So foul this time is going to go against Mize of the Pride. Ball will go inbound underneath their own basket. As Rojas trying to keep handles, loses it twice to Bird, and finally goes out of bounds. Rojas has got to do a much better job of securing that basketball.
Yeah, he does. It's something he's been struggling with all game.
Yep. That's bringing your 6'4 forward. He's used to playing in the paint, not out their perimeter. And now another foul against Salesian. And this kind of a point, it goes back to what you were saying earlier. This is a team that likes to strip the ball and make steals. And they don't mind if they get a few fouls, reach-in fouls, because they got a lot of depth on the bench.
Exactly.
As Davion Mize, the captain, comes out of the game, and replacing him is Jermaine Edmonds. Edmonds with 3 three-pointers already in the first half. And Flores puts it off to Webster. A three-point attempt now for the Bruins, and that one's good.
That's what you want right there. Drive, get your shooters open on the outside, pass it back out for the wide-open three. That's, they need more of that.
Scales with the shot, and now guess who? It's Edmonds again. This time rebound, Scales, who just drilled that three-pointer for the Bruins. 39-20, leads only 19. They're starting to chip away. Three-point attempt again by the Bruins, and that one's good. Rojas joining the party.
Run now. It's time to start making a run here. This is the perfect time to make it. And after the Legion calls a timeout, and they see what's happening.
Exactly right, partner. They say, we got to slow this Bruin machine down a little bit. It's starting to heat up from the arc. 39-23, Salesian with 5:28 left to go in the third quarter of the Division IV Boys Championship.
KBCSports.com and Play On Sports Network showcase great high school games every week, and now you can access our content using multiple platforms. Follow us on Facebook. Get the latest KBC and Play On news on Twitter, or catch our highlights in high definition on YouTube. All of our content can now link you to your favorite social media sites. Share all the high school action you see every week. Brought to you by your home for high school sports, KBCSports.com and PlayOnSports.com.
And from St. Mary's College in Moraga, California, it is the North Coast Boys and Girls Basketball Championship. We've already seen the Division IV champion crowned, the Salesian Lady Pride, with their come-from-behind victory against St. Mary's. Now it's the boys' turn. The Salesian basketball team, last year's Division IV champion, looking to make it two in a row. They hold a 39-23 lead against the St. Vincent St. Pat's Bruins. But the Bruins, with six unanswered points off 2 three-pointers, they're starting to feel a little bit. They're going to get back into this ball game.
Yes, have to make the opportunities when they get them if they're going to chip away at this game, and that's what they're doing now. And they keep it up, we might have a good game here come fourth quarter.
Let's see what happens. Back to the wing, to the perimeter, and a three-point attempt just like that by Markel Leonard kind of spoils the party for the Bruins. 42-23. Yeah.
And yes, Legion just shooters all over the court.
Webster going to drive the baseline. Nice play. That might fall. It does.
Excellent.
Webster showing a great deal of courage. And wait a minute. Are they going to call a charge? Whoa, that is a charging call against Webster.
And the fans of the Bruins are not happy with that.
The Mean Green fans definitely not happy. That was a great drive to score, and it looked like he had fouled. But instead, the call is reversed, and he is charged with a foul. And Salesian will get the ball on the turnover. Dunn leads the point. Dunn and Leonard, boy, they took a little too much on that one. Bunny hop in the pea patch for Mario Dunn, traveling, and gives the ball back to the Bruins.
And that's what you have to be careful with when you do the pump fake. A lot of players do a pump fake, just take off running, but the ball has to be dribbling when you take off.
That's part of the game, is dribbling. Scales brings the ball down across the timeline for the Bruins. 42-23, 4:46 left to go in the third. Flores going to drive him with high off the glass. Tipped in. Wow! Who was that? That was Jordan Hickman with the high tip. He had an arm well over the rim.
That's what you call being aware, and that's what they knew. The Bruins are playing with a lot of excitement here in the second half.
That time, and that may go to the Bruins, and a bad pass that time by Edmonds, and St. Vincent St. Pat's gets it back. They're trailing 42-25. But they're starting to slowly get back into this ball game with 4:29 left to go in the third. And now having a rough time, and stolen this time by Bird. And Bird throws it against the face of Jordan Hickman, and the ball goes out of bounds. Hickman's face like a backboard.
Excellent recognition by Bird. Woo. There. Notice that his momentum wasn't going to be able to stop him. Threw it back in to throw it off the other player, and maybe able to, and Salesian is able to keep the ball.
And off the grill of Hickman, and Salesian keeps the basketball. Poor Hickman didn't even know that was coming.
And the ref is talking to these two players here about something. I don't.
Maybe a little
trash talking going on down there.
Sportsmanlike conduct a little bit here and there. And Salesian takes the ball inside now on their side of the court. Leonard's already been hot from three there. Swings it back over to Dunn. Dunn's going to go baseline. Reverse layup. Good!
What a play.
Unbelievable. No one stopped the baseline. 44-25. Salesian, 4:10 left to go in the third quarter. Flores yo-yoing up and down. Got to be careful with that dribble. Now Webster being harassed by Dunn. Hickman, who's already got a bloody nose. This time, shot for three. Good! Cyrus Scales. Bruins trying to keep it close, 44-28.
They're doing everything they need to do to get back into this game. Just keep it up.
Trailing by 16. 3:45 left to go in the third quarter. Salesian in control, but the Bruins playing a great third quarter. Leonard thought about it from the three. He's going to flip it back out to Dunn. Dunn now against Hickman, trying to go one-on-one. He's going to flip it back out to Edmonds. Edmonds instead going to let someone else shoot it. Leonard's going to drive the key, bounces back to Edmonds. Edmonds on the baseline and going to be fouled by Rojas.
Smart foul there. That Salesian hasn't been hitting a lot of their free throws this game, so let's see what this one is for.
That was a lot of good ball movement by Salesian in that series. They really worked the ball around. That's a lot of discipline on their offense. And going to the line is Jermaine Edmonds with 3:25 left to go in the third quarter. Salesian holding a 44-28 lead over St. Vincent St. Pat's. The Bruins, a number 7 seed, worked their way all the way to the title game here. In fact, St. Vincent St. Pat's only finished 4th in the Bayshore League, snuck into the playoff brackets as a number 7, have made it all the way here to the championship game. And from the way they've played this quarter, I can see why.
Yeah, definitely. They just have heart. That's what you call heart when you get able to squeak into the playoffs and just make it all the way to the championships. You see it so many times in other sports also. That's just called hard, an effort.
You know, Jalen Canty back in the game after going out after a tough fall.
And that's good to see because they need him, especially on this run they're going on now.
So Webster brings the ball across midcourt for the Bruins, 45-28. Salesian with the lead. And there's Canty going to go with this turnaround. This time, no good. That almost went back in. That was almost tipped in by Salesian. And now the Pride on the attack, running quick. A nice bounce pass to Bird. Bird on the reverse layup. Oh, that was a pretty play.
Bird with his athleticism, one of the top players in the nation, showing why he is one of the top players in the nation.
Dunn with a nice feed. This time Flores is going to go into the big trees. And he's going to get called for a charge. I'm going to keep an eye on how many fouls that Flores has. That might be his 4th.
And with Tagaloa down on the inside now, it's going to be a lot harder for Canty to back down in the post now.
Yeah, I'm not driving in the key with a 6'8", 3'10", man standing there right at the free throw line. And Salesian with the basketball. Pump fake. Evans going to put this one up. No good. He was off balance with that shot. Rebound goes to the Bruins. 2:43 left to go in the third quarter. As Webster brings the ball up court, taking it on his own. This time he's going to go right into the big man and then picking up the glass is Canty. Webster showing a lot of bravery going right into the 6'8". Tagaloa.
And he does not move.
No, he doesn't.
He plants his feet and there's no movement.
There's a concrete tower. 47-30, it's a 17-point Salesian lead with 2:17 left to go in the third quarter. The Bruins hanging tough here. Playing that 2-3, actually almost a 3-2, and that ball's tipped away, and a good job by Flores to tip that ball away.
Way to get your hands up.
Scales with it now. Three-point attempt up, in and out, no good. Rebound goes to Bird of Salesian. They really could have used that one.
Oh, yeah, definitely. That could have put a big spark into this game.
Edmonds thought about it for a second and pulled back. Put it back to his guard, Juwan Harrison. 1:45 left to go in the third. 17-point Salesian lead, and it looks like they're slowing it down here. It's Bird now at the top. Sets up the offense. Back to the wing, and they're going to fetch it to Tagaloa inside. Oh, that's the big man lumbering. He loses the ball in the key. Brought it down too low. He can't do that. And that one's going to be nearly intercepted. Webster's able to get it. He goes into the big trees. What a pass to Canty. Score it.
Great job.
Oh, great recognition by Webster to get the ball to Canty inside. 47-32. The lead is now just 15.
This is doable. This is very, very doable. Let's just keep playing like this. Legion is making a lot of mistakes this quarter.
1:09 left to go in the third quarter. So Legion slowing it up. Bird with the ball now. He's being harassed. He's swinging around the perimeter. Salesian looking for an opening inside. A lot of pushing and shoving. And I think it's going to be Canny who's going to get called for trying to push Tagaloa. I don't know how you possibly do that. It's like running into a wall. But Canny will get his third foul. That'll be the fifth team foul for the Bruins with 52 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Like the way the Bruins are playing this third quarter.
Yeah, I don't know what the coach told me in the locker room, but, hey, they made it this far. And they played this Salesian four times already, so they should know their pattern and try to get something working here.
Leonard inside to Tagaloa on the sky hook. Oh, the big man drills it. What a great shot.
And there's nothing much you can do about that.
Nothing you can do about that. A 6'8 man with a nice touch. Three-point attempt by Webster. Up high, over, sits on top. Almost tipped in. Great rebound. Second chance is no good. Oh, look at Tagaloa throws that elbow right at Canny's chest, and he's looking around like, what do you mean?
Yeah, and then Tagaloa, the big Tagaloa, throwing that elbow into Canny's chest like that's enough to drop somebody.
I'm surprised Canny is still on his feet. Yeah, he may be surprised, but that was a pretty serious elbow he threw. Not happy about coming off the court with his third foul. Last guy in this arena who I want to make angry at me is Tagaloa.
Yeah, he's definitely the biggest man in this whole stadium.
He's still on the fence. Still can't understand what it was he's getting called for. I thought that was legal. So underneath the basket, tough pass into Flores, but able to get it down. And Scales going to drive the baseline, flip it out. This time slipped away, one pass too many. Put the ball in the key. Picked up by, I don't know, but tipped by everybody. Everybody's on the ball, and now Salesian's got it. And this one's going to be a foul against Webster as both him and Mize went diving for the basketball. Both teams just battling for loose balls off the glass.
This game is getting testy now. It's getting really physical now as both teams are starting to feel the urgency coming as the fourth period is starting to come along.
16 seconds left to go in this third period. 49-32, Salesian lead, but the Bruins will not relent. They're going to take him toe-to-toe. And looking for the last shot is Salesian of this third quarter. Fires out to Edmonds. Way up to the top. Dunn now looking for the back door. Got it. And a layup. That was a pretty play to Edmonds. And they caught the Bruins napping on the backside.
Yeah, the Bruins.
No time left. Desperation shot. No good. But excellent execution by Salesian on that final play. It gives them a 51-32 lead going into the fourth quarter here on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv.
You can watch highlights or replay of today's game in our on-demand section, and you can also buy a DVD or Blu-ray of today's game right on CIFNorthCoast.tv. Click on Buy DVD, or you can order today's game right now. Have a game that lasts a lifetime brought to you by CIFNorthCoast.tv, and don't forget to stay tuned for the CIFNorthCoast.tv postgame show where we will select our player of the game as well as wrap up all the action from this ball game. That's coming up following the game on CIFNorthCoast.tv.
T.C. Wardell alongside Howard Mills and the Davies brothers, James on the video, Stephen behind the laptop doing our engineering for tonight's game. Division 4 championship on the line. Salesian going into the fourth quarter with a 51-32 lead against the St. Vincent St. Pat Bruins. But really, Howard, I was impressed by how the Bruins came out at halftime and played an outstanding third quarter.
They came out on fire, came out scoring the first points of the second half and kind of went on a run. Salesian still able to keep their foot down a little bit but have been making mistakes this third quarter. And if the Bruins can carry their third quarter play into the fourth quarter, we might have an exciting game here at the end.
See what they can do, trailing by 19 right now. And the Bruins will get the ball to start the fourth quarter. And it's Flores yo-yoing up and down, taking on Edmonds. Off to Scales, tough defense inside. Canny in the paint, 17, sixth quarter is good. You know, they can use a lot more of that.
Yeah, that's what they need to get. They have to give him more touches on the inside.
51-34, just underway here in the fourth quarter of this Division 4 North Coast Section Championship game. Salesian, the defending champions, looking to make it two in a row. But the Bruins of St. Vincent St. Pat's going to have a little something to say about it. As Salesian working inside to Edmonds, back outside to Parker. Good defense now shown by the Bruins. Turnaround jumper, that's out of control, no good. Rebound into Flores' hands. And he'll move the ball up court quickly. And Quick Webster gets it up there. And a charging. No, that's going to be a blocking foul against Salesian. Last time Webster did that, he got called for it.
Wait.
And guess what? That's the second time Webster got called for a charge. That is a tough, tough call.
Yeah, tough break for it just seems like St. Vincent, St. Patrick just can't get nothing going their way this game.
Definitely not getting any breaks by the officials. 7:06 left to go in this ballgame. 51-34, Salesian. Webster showing all kinds of grit to go into the paint, but he's come away short a couple of times with charging fouls.
Salesian's just kind of running the clock down there.
They are. They know they're in control by 17. They're going to swing around the perimeter, then inside. A nice play inside out. And fouled on the drive is Edmonds. That was pretty passing. I'll tell you, the Salesian basketball team, you could tell they're extremely disciplined. They do excellent execution. They know where everyone's going to be. They move without the ball, and that's the sign of a well-coached basketball team.
Exactly. And kind of resembles De La Salle from last night with their coaching and their style of play. I actually would like to see Salesian and De La Salle go at it.
You know, that'd be a heck of a ball game. You know, De La Salle really likes to slow it down with that Princeton-style offense, backdoor cuts, a lot of weaving at the top of the key. And against the Salesian team, kind of different. And they both execute well, but Salesian really likes to run. I'm not sure De La Salle's got quite the athlete
to
run
with
Salesian, but they would slow the game down significantly.
Yeah. It'd be a great matchup.
Might see it in the playoffs. We'll see what happens. Second offering, no good by Salesian, but they lead 52-34 with 6:42 left to go in this ball game. And bringing the ball up, looking for someone to throw to Flores. It finally gets it. And this defense by Salesian just will not relent. Flores from the baseline, going to give it to Kenny. Kenny's going to go into the paint. That's a two-footer, not good. And now on the foul on the floor against Salesian. Boy, they need to get the ball to Kenny more. He does a good job of finding space and making moves inside the paint.
Yeah, and he's when Tagaloa's not down the inside, it's real easy for him to get right up under that net and score easy goals. So definitely something they want to look at.
So the Bruins will get the ball underneath their own basket. 6:27 left to go in this ball game. 52-34 Salesian trying to get in the inbound. Looks like a three-point attempt coming up. No, he's inside the arc. And that's short, and there's a rebound going to Salesian. That's Leonard quickly up court. Look at Dunn. That's just a track meet. Look at those two run.
Man, this is the speed of Salesian is just unbelievable.
Dunn on the easy layup, 54-34, a 20-point Salesian lead. Unbelievable quickness with Leonard and Dunn. Dunn is just, must have been on a 4-3 on that. And now a foul against Edmonds, I believe, is going to be called. Rather, that's going to be Parker on the foul against Canty as they try to get that ball inside to the big man of the Bruins. 6:05 left to go in this ball game. It's a 20-point Salesian lead. They're in cruise control, but the Bruins of St. Vincent, St. Pat's, they're just not letting go. Flores gets the ball to Canty. Down at the block, Canty spins inside, seven-footer. Good, beautiful Excellent. Shot. He is just hot at that turnaround jumper.
Yes, just keep feeding him. So they can stop it, keep feeding him.
That's Canty's 10th point of the game. 54-36, 5:48 left to go in this Division IV championship game. Salesian more than happy to slow it down. There's Leonard, no one covering him. He's just yo-yoing up and down near the mid-court line. They're going to have to get out of this 2-3 zone and start pressing, and then Flores loses a steal opportunity. Three-point attempt, no good. Backside, wide open. Nobody blocked off the backside, and Parker gets a cheap 2 points.
Yeah, and the Bruins are going to have to just have to start closing in on these players a little bit more.
Flores from 12 feet out just put that one up with a man in his face. 56-38, Bruins playing tough. 5 minutes left to go in this Division IV title game. And Salesian will take their time on offense. And as I say that, Leonard shoots into the lane, flings it right back outside to Harrison. Harrison inside to Bird. Bird at the block, inside. Blocked Ooh. By Canty, just sent that home. But picking up the trash is Jeffrey Parker for the score, but Canty sends a message to Bird.
Signed, sealed, and delivered, like Stevie Wonder would say.
Absolutely. 58-38. Salesian still up by 20. Flores going to wing that one from three. No good. Rebound, Bird. And here come the Pride. Bird going to drive the lane, taking himself. He tried to dunk on Canty. Canty fouls him, stares him down, and says, don't even come into my house again.
Whoa, what a matchup right there.
Ego versus ego.
Canty making a statement. Nah, not on this, not in this lane.
You're not going to do that. You're not going to make that dunk on me. There's a foul on Canty. That'll be his fourth, I believe. But he said that's a, I'm sure he doesn't mind giving that one up. As Bird tried to go from almost the free throw line to dunk.
That was two great, almost two great powers going at each other. Could have cracked, put a crack in the floor with that collision there.
Those two guys are going to go at it next year. Canty only a sophomore, Bird only a junior. And believe me, there's some bad blood as Canty still staring down Bird who's at the free throw line. He's a little fired up. 4:29 left to go in this ballgame as Bird's first free throw is good, making it a 21-point Salesian lead.
That's the great thing about competition. You like to see you got two great players just going at it like that.
Yeah, it makes
you just love to
great.
See that.
Yeah. Irregardless of the score, yeah, you got two players who just want it. As Bird's second free throw attempt is good. 60-38 Salesian, locking this one up with 4:29 left to go in the fourth quarter. In this Division IV championship, as Flores brings the ball in across the timeline. Scales now, in this Salesian defense, not giving up. Canty wants to go baseline. He finds some space. Look at him go up. Look at that shot by Canty from 4 feet out.
Yeah.
He went baseline, cut back inside, and just put it in Bird's face.
Yeah, when he's deep on the inside like that, there's just nothing you can do about that. And kind of wish they was able to do that earlier in the game. But
number 23 is matching up tonight. Is Canty with a little bit of attitude. And we get this one down low. Canty looking to get another one. No, he had to give that one up to Bird. Let Bird dunk on that one because he knew that would have been his fifth. 62-40, Salesian. 3:46 left to go. That one near steal. As the Bruins swing it back outside. Scales now looking over to Flores. Canty looking for some room inside. He's calling for the basketball, and there he gets it. And brings it up and fouled by Edmonds. And Edmonds says, hey, that's jump ball. And Canty says, no, you got a piece of my arm there, pal. I'm going to the line for that.
Canty deep on the inside again. Definitely would have been an easy bucket. Smart foul by Salesian.
Seventh team foul for Salesian as Canty goes in the line to shoot two. And sophomore big man hits the front one, 62-41. Salesian's pretty much going to pull this one out with 3:32 left to go in a 21-point lead. But boy, I have been impressed by the St. Vincent St. Patrick's team in the second half of this ball game. And they got a lot of young players coming back next week here.
Yeah, they're going to be somebody to look forward to next year, definitely.
Tagaloa back in the game for Salesian. How can I tell? Because the gym is rumbling as he runs. Edmonds going to look for it, give to Tagaloa. Tagaloa is trying to get the handle. He puts it up. No good. Tagaloa with the rebound. Everybody get out of my way. Whoa, he almost threw a punch. He almost hit Rojas in the back. He got a little angry.
Yeah, he's definitely getting a little testy, you could tell. And
you saw that right hand kind of come up.
Could have caused a lot of damage.
So the big man, the 6'8", 3'10", center for Salesian will go to the line to shoot two. Hope he doesn't shatter the backboard. Hey, that's not a bad touch for a big man.
Not a bad touch at all for a big man.
He says, Bird walks up to him and says, make the second one, I'll get you a Subway sandwich after the game. 3:17 left to go. Salesian locking this up, their second consecutive Division IV title with a 63-41 lead. As Tagaloa this time can't hit the second. Rojas with a rebound for the Bruins. And Leonard still putting on the press against Flores. They're just not giving up on defense. They swing it back out to Rojas for three from the wing. Off the iron, no good, and here comes Leonard. Almost too fast, and it was too fast. He barely gets onto the ball. Looks underneath the Bird by himself, slam dunk! And that brings the crowd to their feet, 65-41.
And that is putting an exclamation mark on this game.
Wow. Bruins with the ball, still double teamed at the top. Salesian just won't put the foot off the gas. Rojas underneath, going to go against Tagaloa. Yeah, run into that wall.
All he has to do is put his hands up.
He doesn't even get off the floor. Those size 17s are on the ground. They're planted like roots. And you just got to find a way to try to get over them. Ball goes out of bounds to the Bruins. 2:34 left to go in this ball game. Nice cut by Rojas. Rojas underneath, good play.
Great up and under there by Rojas to get the score.
And a timeout on the court by the Bruins. They need to slow it down. But it's all Salesian, 65-43 with 2:29 left to go in this ball game.
KBCSports.com and Play On Sports Network showcase great high school games every week, and now you can access our content using multiple platforms. Follow us on Facebook, get the latest KBC and Play On news on Twitter, or catch our highlights in high definition on YouTube. All of our content can now link you to your favorite social media site. Share all the high school action you see every week, brought to you by your home for high school sports, KBCSports.com and Play On Sports Network.
From St. Mary's College in Moraga, California, we thank you for joining us here on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv. The Division IV Boys Championship pretty much all wrapped up by Salesian, 65-43, only 2:29 left to go in this ballgame. Boy, folks, don't go away. We have got two huge backyard brawls coming at 5 o'clock and 7 o'clock tonight here from St. Mary's College. Bishop O'Dowd of Oakland taking on Miramani Lady Matadors, the undefeated Matadors, taking on the number one seed Bishop O'Dowd Dragons. That is a huge rivalry here in the neighborhood. So I
really excited about one. That is going to be something to see.
I suggest you stay on board for that 5 o'clock tip-off, and the boys' game at 7 o'clock is another backyard brawl, which is going to be some exciting basketball. Two local teams here in Moraga going at it, and they do not like each other at all. 2:29 left to go in this ball game, and Salesian going to take it out under the basket and suddenly call out on the field. We're going to bring some new players into the game now. Canty, Flores, and Webster on the floor now for the Bruins. Not exactly sure what happened. I'm not sure either, but all I see is the big 6'8", 3'10 center at the free throw line. Who in their right mind would foul him?
Man.
So something must have happened on the other side of the court where Tagaloa was fouled, and he'll go to the line to shoot two as the Bruins are into the penalty with 10 team fouls. Tagaloa's first offering, crunch, backboard, no good, 2:29 left to go. We might see some wholesale changes for Salesian in the next minute or two, as this one is all said and done with a 65-43 lead. As Tagaloa with a beautiful touch.
Beautiful.
Little string music there on that free throw. Makes it 66-43. He walks back off the court. And takes a seat and moves two guys next to him out of the way. Flores with the ball down court for the Bruins. Webster going to drive the key. A beautiful finger roll. No good. And another charge against Webster. That's his third. And he is absolutely frustrated. He's got to be. He has been doing a great job driving the lane. And three times he's been called for charges.
And I'm not sure about that call there. It looks like the player's feet was still moving when he was trying to get set.
Well, I think all three of them were tough calls. 2:20 left to go in the ball game, and a quick timeout on the court. Looks like it's going to be a 30-second variety. 66-43. Salesian looking, getting ready for their second consecutive Division IV crown. As we were talking about early, Salesian's going to make some noise in the state playoffs. There's no question about it. And there's some teams down south in Southern California that do not want to see the Salesian basketball team.
That's true. That's
on the
true.
Court.
That'd be some great matchups. I know SoCal got a lot of teams down there that can run just as good as Salesian. So there's a good opportunity to see some good basketball there.
So Salesian with 2:20 left to go in the ball game. We'll take the ball, inbound the ball. Leonard will take it up, and Flores. Oh, Dunn picked up his dribble, and Flores will take on Leonard. Leonard able to get the ball across the timeline. As they spread it out here for the Pride. Swing it over to Bird. Bird's going to go up high, and Bird is hammered. Ball almost went in, and boy, he took a shot.
And that was Canty, his rival here in this pass. Few quarters here knocking him down with a hard foul.
That was a hard foul. That'll be Canny's fifth. And probably a good idea to get him off the court. He's played an outstanding basketball game. Actually, they're going to give it is his fifth. 13 points for Canty today for the Bruins. A great, outstanding ball game, especially in the paint on offense. And he'll go off with five fouls.
He's not a guy you can replace easily.
And he's definitely frustrated. Yeah, that's a good idea to him.
So Ryan Stewart, the 6'7 freshman, back in for Canny, who had fouled out for the Bruins. He's just a sophomore. He's got some outstanding moves in the paint. He's going to be someone to watch over the next couple of years. Bird's first free throw is good. Jabari Bird, junior forward for Salesian, ranked 20th, number 20th ranked junior by Max Preps, and a number of Pac-10 teams already starting to salivate over this young man's talents. 2 minutes left to go in this Division IV final. Flores brings the ball up. Him and Leonard have been battling all game long.
All game. Great matchup here.
It really has been. Flores, an outstanding ball handler, can get a little too cute sometimes, a little too much between the legs, but a tremendous job, and Leonard's going to be called for the reach-in foul, which is atypical for a Salesian basketball team.
Yep.
They're looking for the steal. Even when they're up by 25, they're looking for the steal. As Flores goes to the line to shoot 1-1. Hits the first one. It's a 68-44 lead for Salesian with 1:56 left to go in the ballgame. The next game tonight, the 5 o'clock matchup between Bishop O'Dowd and Miramani for the Division III ladies title. It's going to be a tremendous matchup, one of the better games you're probably going to see. And into the game now for the Bruins is Marcus Aducado, the 5'7" freshman. And he looks like he's about 5'3". He's not 5'7".
No, there's no way. No way.
That's a misprint. But he's in a guard now for the Bruins. And big rebound by Bird off the miss, and he gets it right back inside. There's really nobody there to contest Bird in the paint.
Well, can't see out. That's something that he can do all day with them long arms like that. It's easy for him to get those rebounds.
Bruins got two freshmen, and they're starting to bring in some of their reserves. That's a big boy right there, ready to come into the game for the Bruins. Aducado with a shot. Three-pointer, air ball, no good. And here comes Bird. This could be something special. Oh, what a jam by Jabari Bird. And he stares down Scales.
And that's what the people here have been waiting to see, a little breakaway by Bird there to go down with the jam.
Scales not even looking in his direction. Says, yeah, I'll give it that one. He had a breakaway dunk. Good job. And here comes some wholesale changes for both teams. As both teams start emptying the bench. Who is that? That's number 34, Matt Thomas, 6'2 senior. That's a big kid.
He's
bigger than 6'2".
Well, he might be pushing 6'4 there.
He doesn't miss too many meals as he goes into the Bird at the free throw line to complete the three-point play. And does. He's an outstanding free throw shooter. You know, and that's something that recruiters really look at from a big man. You know, it's one thing to have talent and be able to run or be able to play well in the paint. Boy, if you can shoot free throws,
exactly.
That's become a lost art these days.
Especially for a big man.
Exactly. 1:13 left to go in the ballgame. Freshmen everywhere for this Bruins team. And as you can tell, because they lose that one immediately. And that's Bernard Ward trying to take it. Oh, almost triple jumps that on the layup. Those are two long strides as Ward converts on the layup. 30-point advantage now. It's under a minute to play. These freshmen for both teams.
Yeah, you can definitely to see the inexperience.
A lot of youth on the court right now for both programs. An opportunity for both to get some playing time, and I like to see this from both coaches.
And that's good that they get time to come in a game like this to see the kind of competition that be going in, because this is the future of their team.
Absolutely right. Michael Page with a penalty, with a foul, rather. And that'll send Aducado, the 5'7 freshman for the Bruins, to go to the line. And Aducado makes the front end of a 1-on-1. And he gets his name in the box scores here in the championship game. There's just no way he's 5'7".
Yeah. That's a good touch on the ball.
He does have good touch. Good free throws, both of them, Aducado of the Bruins. 39 seconds left to go. As quickly down court, these guys are excited to play as Page. Page wants it all by himself, loses the ball, gets it over to Ward. Three-point attempt. Up and no good. Rebound picked up by the Bruins. He didn't even have a jersey number for that young man. As Aducado goes man-to-man, gets a nice pick, but loses the ball.
And here comes a fast break, and there is another pick. Good job by Sherman. Sherman swings it out to Ajikado for three and drills it. Hey, he's got 5 points. Okay. He's walking into the game, and I'm giving him grief about his height. Ajikado with 5 points. Nails the three-pointer. They let this one go. And Salesian has won their second consecutive Division IV title with a 75-50 win over St. Vincent, St. Patrick's. We'll be back in just a few moments with our post-game show, and we'll try to get a player of the game interview as well here on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv.
Does anybody know where he's going? Tagalo's going. He got to be going somewhere to play football next year.
That thing, you got to
go. He's going to Cal.
He's going to Cal.
Oh, okay. That's why he's going. He had to go somewhere.
Fourth and 10 from the 41-yard line for St. Augustine. Kennedy dropping back to pass. Looking left, firing, incomplete, okay. Intended for Noland. No penalty flags on the field. Mar Vista will take over on downs, and Jordan Lertique will take that knee, and the Mar Vista Mariners knock off the number 2-seeded St. Augustine Saints at Mesa College in a dominating performance on both sides of the football for Mar Vista. They trailed 14-0 and came back.
Again, down 2-0, facing adversity, and they've really just turned the table around since game number 3. Set an attack, great block made back inside the Maverick zone. A chance there by Bosback back inside the Maverick zone. Ball attack there by Bosback. A second opportunity by Bosback. Lift violation call. Winner. Oh. It's an over the net call. Oh, my goodness. Bosback reached over on the attack. A Maverick error wraps up the title for the Presentation Panthers. A 15-9 victory in game number 5. And they wrap it up coming back from 2-0 down match-wise and take it 3-2.
36-35 and driving. And oh, baby! Shrigley with a jam, and it was with emphasis. And it's the foul, and listen to these fans.
Do you know who's standing up right behind us? Tony Bland, who is the head recruiter for San Diego State. I think he's drooling. Somebody get that man a napkin.
Quick score on this drive. There goes a handoff to Zeller, trying to go straight ahead, but he is met by Will. Now he breaks out to the outside, gets across the 30, 35, on the right, 40, midfield. He's running down the sidelines. He's going to go all the way as he's at the 10, 5, touchdown. Patrick Zeller got, he stood up at the line of scrimmage and broke out to his left to the far sidelines, and he was in a foot race, and he went all the way for the touchdown, broke a tackle, and made it nice and showed his speed as he got outside for the touchdown.
Back in the backfield to the left is Campbell. Hernandez takes a snap, play action to Campbell. Looks down the field. Now here comes the pressure. He's going to be hit. He breaks the tackle, rolls left. Now he's going to cut up field. He's going to break another tackle, and then another tackle down the sideline. Gets a block inside the 5. What a touchdown! Hernandez goes 33 yards in spectacular fashion, breaking 4 tackles along the way, including 2 in the backfield, and Hilltop has tied this one up at 29.
And reasonably so. He's been doing a good job of leading this offense. Looking for his first touchdown pass of the season for Ray Hudson. And Ray Hudson gets both feet inside the end zone. Touchdown Foothill.
Like you said earlier, 6'2 body frame, and can probably what we just saw there was getting Randy Moss, was what we call getting Moss. Clearly just leaped over the defender there, landed both feet in bounds.
Grant with a big, strong defensive rebound. He brings it back down the floor again in another slam dunk. Jeremy Grant can run the point, and he can fly. Huge dunk, 2 big dunks in the last minute.
Bullard trying to close it out. Deep ball, up in the air, Cram. Bringing it back, Arbizo. Cram over in 3, free opportunity. Look for Rodabaugh. No, pass middle, Weimer.
Ball game.
25-19, Foothill wins it 3-1.
because this kid has definitely proven that he can make things happen here in this ballgame.
They will go with him. Bula Graft on a stretch run, just breaking tackles. The little man is in the clear to Torrey territory. The 25, the 20, the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Knights. What a run, the freshman, Bula Graft.
Ooh, I tell you what. There were at least three times on that run that he should have gone down or he should have been wrapped up. Missed tackles there, cost La Jolla Country Day as Bula Graft, the freshman running back for Bishops, is able to take it in. And that was a determined run there, Andy, by.
So first and 10, Brandon Lewis in the shotgun has time to throw, and he will fire, and he has a mad diving catch. Did he hold on to it? He did. What a catch from Kendall Keys. And that may be the KBC Sports Player of the Week.
What a catch. By he laid himself out there, and a great throw, as you said. Read it nicely, did Lewis, and really caught his receiver on the go. And just kind of put it out there right on the outskirts of his fingertips. He laid out, and he made it.
He might be called upon to make a crucial kick. Second down and 8 after the 2-yard gain on the receiver screen. And Paulson fires across the right seam for Jack Finney, who makes a catch. Stiffs arms the defender at the 50 and is finally brought down at the Amador Valley 45-yard line. Flags flying late on the play.
Go for it. 4th and 3. They figure 3 is easier to get than the field goal at this point. And it's Paulson looking for Finney. Right seam, side, right seam, touchdown. Jack Finney makes the catch. Bounces off a defender. A 23-yard pass and catch from Paulson to Finney. And the Foothill Falcons are back out in front.
They certainly are. Finney lining up a tight end. I had a feeling that Paulson was going to look right side there as Chase Miller was lined up. Receiver far side. But instead it was Finney straight to the post. And Paulson picks him out in stride again. The third catch on the drive for Finney.
Give it to Tyree on an exchange against the zone. Do a little three-man weave. This is Tyrell back with it. Tyrell's going to go lob back door. Tyree Robinson with a flush.
Now that was nice. Very nice design play.
Uwaba back there. Bogart takes a snap. He's going to run the play. He's going to throw. He's got a man open at the 10. It's underthrown. It's incomplete. No, or is it caught? It is a catch. Wow, juggling catch inside the 5-yard line. Moliga, was that Moliga pulling that one in? It is Moliga. Boy, that ball was deflected by one of the Falcons, and then Moliga, he lands on the ground and pulls it in. What a catch.
Set up with three men in the backfield, back to the wing. This time inside counter to Telefaro. No, they're going to throw this one. He's got a man open, and a great, what a catch!
What a grab by tight end Joe Gigantino. He must have bobbled that ball 4 times in the air, and he was actually tipped by the defender and had the presence of mind to keep his concentration and make the grab. Unbelievable catch. And the ball at the 29-yard line of the Eagles, and you can see the defense, they're still bewildered. How did he come up with that
grab? Unfazed, even with 2 defenders around him and 4 big. That's so unconventional for a guy to handle the ball so well.
January! Oh. With a one-hand jam.
He was not going to be denied there. Coming over was Milmo.
Bradshaw Christian's going to bring the starting unit out on the field one more time just to take a knee. 10 seconds left. They better hurry it up. Actually, they're going to try a field goal for Lawson. They're going to run out of time. Are they going to take? There's a snap. And they aren't even going to get the kickoff. They tried to hustle Lawson out there for a field goal opportunity to see if they could get her one, but it does not matter. They don't get the punt off in time. Drew Ricker just got the Gatorade shower on the sideline. Bradshaw Christian is your winner, 62-6, the final score. They are your D6 titleists this year here in 2000.
5 seconds left, clock winding down. Poway has won the title.
56-0 over the Vista Panthers. The championship goes to Poway.
Well, your double wing T option offense down by 5. They're going to have to spread it out. They go with 3 receivers to the near side. That's the short side. 1 solo left.
Back to throw. McHugh under pressure. Rolls out of it. Now he's dumped and dropped. And that's the last thing they could handle. And that's not what they could do. Bellarmine now can't stop the clock. 4-3. And that is going to do it. Santa Margarita coming back from the dead has won the Division I State Bowl Championship 42-37 in an improbable comeback against Bellarmine of San Jose. And the Bellarmine players on the field, on their knees, just absolutely dejected after playing just a gut-wrenching football game.
About how he was going to throw the football on this play, and Westlake might have been daring him to do so. Just joking, though, folks. Peros is going to take a knee. He does. That's going to wrap it up. Well, I'll tell you what. Westlake had an outstanding year. They win the Southern Section title, never easy. They went 14-0 coming in. They're going to finish 14-1. And there is no shame in losing to the De La Salle Spartans. De La Salle wins at 35-0. KBCSports.com postgame show.
Nina Holmes to serve. Needs a good one. Serve is over. Back in one. Off Panthers. Here's the chance. Peterson outside. Kuntz up in the air. Holmes brings it back.
What a save.
Free opportunity for the Wolves. Peterson to Brown on the slide.
There it is. What a game. Lots of emotions.
The Shasta Wolves have won their first championship since 1999.
34 seconds to go. There's the snap. The knee for Sierra Canyon. They actually don't have to snap the football again. 25 seconds to play, and the celebration is beginning on the far side of the football field for the Sierra Canyon Trailblazers. 15 seconds left. What a third quarter performance by Sierra Canyon. They don't need any points in the fourth quarter, Manny. They are going to take this championship game with a 34-13 win over the LeGrand Bulldogs. Sierra Canyon wins the Small Schools Division Championship by 21 points over the LeGrand Bulldogs. An outstanding performance by Sierra Canyon in the second half.
Before it goes 10 yards.
Here we go. Antezana with a kick. It's a bouncer, and then it's recovered by Washington.
And I don't even think Washington Union has to run another play. Maybe they got to run one more.
Well, that's going to take...
I think that'll do it.
Yeah, that's going to take the Panthers to 14-0. Cap off the first state championship in the Central Section. And congratulations to both teams for really a hard-fought game on both sides. It was entertaining for us.
Very entertaining. The Washington Union Panthers, your 2011 Division III California State Champions.
Fourth and 10 from the 41-yard line for St. Augustine. Kennedy dropping back to pass. Looking left, firing. Incomplete intended for Noland. No penalty flags on the field. Mar Vista will take over on downs. And Jordan Lertik will take that knee. And the Mar Vista Mariners knock off the number two-seeded St. Augustine Saints at Mesa College in a dominating performance on both sides of the football for Mar Vista.
And we are back here on Play On Sports in association with CIFNorthCoast.tv. You have just been watching the Salesian Pride go back-to-back Division IV titles with a 75-50 victory over St. Patrick St. Vincent. The Bruins, who came out slow, actually made a great second-half run to keep this game relatively close. But in the end, Salesian, with too much speed, too much depth on the basketball team, wins out 75-50 convincingly, and they move on to the state playoffs, where they're going to be a tough out for teams up in Northern California and Southern California. Folks, we're going to take a break for a little while. Our next tip-off is at 5 p.m., and I recommend you stay tuned. We are going to have one of the best basketball, girls basketball matchups in the state of California. Bishop O'Dowd of Oakland taking on the undefeated Miramonte High School team, which is going to be a pretty much a backyard brawl. Both teams, both high schools near this facility here at St. Mary's College, so they know each other extremely well. And you're going to see some of the best talent in girls basketball in the state of California. So for Howard Mills, and the brothers James and Stephen Davies, I am T.C. Wardell saying so long for now on PlayOnSports.com, and we hope to see you or hear from you at 5 p.m. for the girls Division III final. We'll be back in just a little bit.